Order, please. We'll now proceed with the daily routine, and we'll begin with the presenting and reading of petitions. The Honourable Member for Inverness.
Mr. Speaker, I beg leave to table a petition, the operative clause stating that calling upon our leaders to act now to make the Colindale Road safe by paving it. There are 629 signatures on this petition, including my own, Mr. Speaker.
Petition is tabled. We'll now move on to presenting reports of committees. Tabling reports, regulations, and other papers. Statements by ministers. The Honourable Minister of Labour and Advanced Education.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, while we're, I am waiting for some guests to arrive in the gallery, so perhaps I could begin my statement, and then after the folks have arrived, then I could in fact introduce them, if that would be possible. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, today is a good day, certainly for many of our post-secondary students and graduates, some of whom are with us in the gallery today. And in fact, Mr. Speaker, I do see them coming in. We're pleased to have several post-secondary students and representatives from Students Nova Scotia in the gallery today. I'd like to quickly introduce them. We have with us Jonathan Williams from Students Nova Scotia, Matthew Rios, who's from Acadia University. We have Danielle Andres from Students Nova Scotia and Allison Sparling from Students Nova Scotia. We also have several of our Crackerjack staff from Labour and Advanced Education, Carol Lowthers and Ken Byron. I would ask that everyone please stand and receive the warm welcome of the House. Mr. Speaker, many Nova Scotian graduates will no longer have to pay interest on their provincial student loans, saving them money as they start their careers. This was a commitment. This was a commitment we made early on, and we're keeping our promise. Mr. Speaker, the average Nova Scotia student loan is about $5,600. Eliminating the interest on that loan will save graduates about $800 over the lifetime of the loan. We know, as do our young people, that every dollar counts when you're beginning your career and starting to repay your student loans. We hope this provides some relief to graduates as they leave campus and enter the workforce. Mr. Speaker, I would be remiss if I did not take a moment to mark the contribution of the penultimate Minister of Advanced Education and Labour, Marilyn Moore. Her efforts to improve the student assistance programs in this province must be commended and moved us from one of the worst student assistance programs in the country to one of the best. When I've been chatting with students, they've told me that this particular measure is going to make a difference to them and to their friends and classmates. In fact, research shows that reducing students' debt plays a critical role in their decisions to stay or leave Nova Scotia after graduation. This is an additional step government is taking to make post-secondary education more affordable and accessible for our students, and hopefully help some more students stay here after they graduate. Mr. Speaker, keeping post-secondary education affordable in Nova Scotia is a priority, and we're working to better support students and graduates. Eliminating the interest on provincial student loans is only one of several efforts we're making toward that goal. New graduate scholarships will put more money into the hands of hundreds of students who are committing to continuing their education and research here in Nova Scotia. And a new Graduate to Opportunity program will help recent grads get to work so they can stay and build their lives and careers here in Nova Scotia. Mr. Speaker, today's students are tomorrow's entrepreneurs, leaders, and skilled workers, and they are the key to Nova Scotia's success. We want them to have the best possible preparation, and we want them to stay and make their lives in Nova Scotia. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Honourable Member for Pictou Centre.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It gives me great pleasure to have this opportunity to say a few words concerning the recent statement. And I guess I can start off by saying that any day is a good day when we can help students across our province, especially students that are at the university level and are borrowing a lot of money to get their education. The many students have very large loans, and I certainly can attest to that. I have six children, all have gone to university, many of them have multiple degrees, and they owe a lot of money. Mr. Speaker, they keep calling home, you know, thinking I have this this vault, you know. However, I keep telling them that that is one major step towards creating a career for them, and I'm very pleased with the path that they have chosen. Again, Mr. Speaker, many of my children have gone out of the province to get their university degrees. I'm not so sure if this particular assistance is any good to them. So I guess a question I have, Nova Scotia students that attend post-secondary schools outside of Nova Scotia, are they eligible for this particular assistance? Or is it just students from Nova Scotia attending university in Nova Scotia? So that's a very important issue, in particular to me, Mr. Speaker. But every dollar counts, and I'm aware of this. I think one of the important things is, Mr. Speaker, one thing is helping out students, which this particular statement clarified. The other thing is, when I think of the Ivany Report, the Ivany Commission, are we creating jobs for them? Is there a job for this particular student or students when they leave university? So it's a two-edged sword there. We are helping them on one end, but on the other end, when they leave post-secondary school, do they have the opportunity to stay in Nova Scotia? Are the jobs available in Nova Scotia for these students? Our greatest resource in Nova Scotia, Mr. Speaker, are our students. And what I would like to see this government do in the incoming months and years is to create the opportunities for our students to stay here after they complete their university career. So, Mr. Speaker, having said those few words, I'll take my seat, but again, I'm looking forward to the government creating the opportunity for students to pursue their post-secondary careers in our province. Thank you.
The Honourable Leader of the New Democratic Party.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I want to thank the Minister for her statement and for providing an advance copy. And in particular, I'd like to thank the Minister for her recognition of the good work of my former colleague, Marilyn Moore, on this file and this initiative. Mr. Speaker, 5 years ago, approximately 5 years ago, Nova Scotia had the worst student aid program in the country. And Mr. Speaker, the report that was commissioned by the previous government by Dr. Tim O'Neill outlined, I think, in very good detail what the problems were and the need to address those problems in our student aid program to make post-secondary education affordable, accessible, and attainable for young people in our province. We all know, Mr. Speaker, that people who have access to post-secondary education, either in our community college system or in our university system, stand a far greater chance in life to be gainfully employed at better levels of income. And so it's incumbent on us, Mr. Speaker, to find ways to make education affordable, accessible, and attainable. And this initiative today is another piece in that puzzle. So we do say this is a good initiative, and it will, in part, relieve a part of the burden that students face with respect to accessibility and affordability. However, it's our hope, Mr. Speaker, that this support does not come at the cost of other supports that currently exist in the system, such as the graduate retention rebate tax credit. This rebate was also introduced in 2009, and it allows graduates, university graduates, to reduce their Nova Scotia income taxes by a maximum of $2,500 per year in the year of graduation and in each of the next 5 years to a maximum of $15,000 over a 6-year period. For students who complete a diploma or certificate programs, the graduate rebate retention program provides a tax credit worth a maximum of $1,250 a year to a maximum of $7,500 over the 6-year period. It's a positive thing that allows students to stay in our province and encourage them to stay in our province. So today's announcement amounts to approximately $800 over the lifetime of a student's loan, as the minister indicated. But again, Mr. Speaker, I hope it doesn't come at the cost of supports, other supports, like the graduate retention rebate, which puts $7,500 to $15,000 back in students' pockets. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
We'll now move on to government notices of motion. The Honourable Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, may I do an introduction before I read my resolution?
Absolutely.
Mr. Speaker, I'd like to draw the attention of the House to your gallery, where we have with us Nancy Kinsman, who has no stranger to this House, who has served 35 years for the people of the province of Nova Scotia and has served 11 speakers in this House of Assembly. Mr. Speaker, I hope she doesn't use the phrase that you're the one that drove her to retirement. But today is her last day, so I would ask Nancy if she would stand and receive the warm congratulations of this House. Speaker, as well with Nancy is Kelly Cantello. Kelly is the new assistant to the Speaker. Kelly, welcome, and we wish you much success in your journey of not only working with the Speaker, but serving the people of this province. Mr. Speaker, hereby give notice on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas today marks the last day here for Nancy Kinsman, Legislative Assistant to the Speaker, before her retirement date, after 35 years of service to the Nova Scotia House of Assembly and its members, including the 11 different speakers who've had the good fortune to work with her, and whereas in addition to the remarkable longevity of Nancy's service to this place, she will be remembered for her welcoming disposition, good humour, and for having been instrumental in our interparliamentary relationships with a variety of organizations, including the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association and the Council of State Governments. And whereas Nancy has been an integral part of the execution of protocol functions for the House of Assembly and has overseen numerous diplomatic visits to our Speaker and has been instrumental in the organization of many large national and international conferences and seminars and has earned the respect of her peers across Canada and abroad, therefore, be it resolved that the House of Assembly offer its highest praise to Nancy Kinsman for her years of dedication to this Parliament and the Speaker and its members, and wish her many years of happiness in her retirement. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Service, Nova Scotia Municipal Relations.
Mr. Speaker, I beg leave to introduce a bill titled
an act to amend Chapter 19 of the Acts of 2006, the Property Evaluation Services Corporation Act.
Order, please. We're a little early on that one. We'll do that in a couple of minutes. Enthusiasm, I like it. That's what a full breakfast will do, see? All right, we'll move on to introduction of bills. The Honourable Minister of Service, Nova Scotia.
Mr. Speaker, once again, I beg leave to introduce a bill titled An Act to Amend Chapter 19 of the Acts of 2006, the Property Evaluation Service Corporation Act.
The Honourable Minister of Service, Nova Scotia, begs leave to introduce an act to amend Chapter 19 of the Acts of 2006, the Property Valuation Services Corporation Act.
Bill number 35, entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 19 of the Acts of 2006, the Property Valuation Services Corporation Act.
Ordered that the bill be read a second time on a future day. The Honourable Leader of the Official Opposition.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I will say I appreciate the eagerness of the Minister who just introduced this bill, clearly a case of premature incorporation, and I just appreciate how keen he is. Mr. Speaker, with that brief note, I would like to beg leave to introduce a bill entitled An Act Respecting the Nova Scotia Commission on Building Our New Economy.
The Honourable Leader of the Official Opposition begs leave to introduce an act respecting the Nova Scotia Commission on Building Our New Economy.
Bill number 36, entitled An Act Respecting the Nova Scotia Commission on Building Our New Economy.
Ordered that the bill be read a second time on a future day. We'll now move on to notices. Do you have one? The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I move that Bill number 32, an act to repeal statutes pertaining to forest agreements, be now read a second time.
No.
Okay.
We're not there yet.
Okay, we're eager. We're eager over here.
We may have to rethink this whole breakfast thing.
If there's no other bills, we're going to move on to notices of motion. The Honourable Leader of the Official Opposition.
Mr. Speaker, in reading this resolution, I just want to join with the Premier and the government in congratulating Nancy Kinsman on her long service and welcoming Kelly Cotrello to the House of Assembly. And having said that, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas today is the last day of Nancy Kinsman's long career with Nova Scotia's public service, and whereas in 1979 Nancy began working on the province's Select Committee on Constitutional Matters and moved to the Speaker's office in 1981, where she has been an invaluable resource to many speakers, and whereas Nancy's knowledge and pleasant demeanor will be sorely missed as she begins her retirement. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House thank Nancy Kinsman for her many years of service to the Legislature and our province, and wish her well as she begins this exciting new chapter in her life. Now, Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Sackville-Cobequid.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move
order,
the adoption
order,
of the
please.
Following.
The Honourable Member for Sackville-Cobequid has the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Whereas the Resource Recovery Fund Board is a nonprofit organization helping Nova Scotians keep our province a beautiful place to live through reducing, reusing, recycling, and recovering resources. And whereas the RRFB held their annual NS Recycling Contest for students from grade primary through 12, receiving more than 6,700 entries from 201 schools. And whereas Cavalier Drive School student Taylor Dominicks, Emma Townsend, and Julia Smith were winners in the film category for grade 7s through 9 in the Halifax Regional Municipality and will be awarded prizes for themselves and their school at an event held on in April of 2014. Therefore, be resolved that the Nova Scotia Legislature congratulate Cavalier Drive School students Taylor Dominicks, Emma Townsend, and Julia Smith on their winning film entry in the Resource Recovery Fund Board's annual NS Recycling Contest and wish them future success. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye. Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for King's South.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Canadian Federation of University Women, CFUW, carries out the important work of improving the status of women and promoting human rights, public education, social justice, and peace. And whereas CFUW Wolfville is made up of 60 dedicated members that support local, national, and international causes. And whereas the CFUW Wolfville is celebrating its 75th anniversary in 2014, therefore be it resolved that the House of Assembly congratulate and thank the Wolfville CFUW on 75 years of dedicated community service and advocacy. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye. Aye. Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Colchester, Musquodoboit Valley.
Yes, Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I will move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas truck drivers are an important part of Nova Scotia's economy, and rarely do you find anyone that's been behind the wheel for 40 years. And whereas Dale Fisher of Brookfield was honored in January by the Fisher Transport Company, where he started driving a truck in 1974 at the age of 20. And whereas Fisher was recognized for his commendable accident-free record, with one co-worker saying, "Dale's work ethic is to be valued by any employer." Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate Dale Fisher of C.E. Fisher Transport in Brookfield for his four decades of hard work and skill as a truck driver. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye. Aye. Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Chester, St. Margaret's.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Sherry Richardson of St. Margaret's Bay, Nova Scotia, while serving in the Navy, has been a member of many Royal Canadian Legion branches. Whereas Sherry has filled many roles as a member of the Legion, such as Treasurer, Secretary, and President. And whereas this past Remembrance Day, Ms. Richardson received a medal for being a member of the Legion for 50 years. Therefore, be it resolved that the Nova Scotia Legislature congratulate Sherry Richardson on her 50 years of service to the Legion and to her community. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Hammonds Plains, Lucasville.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to introduce this on behalf of the Honourable Speaker and MLA for Eastern Shore. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. whereas the people of Eastern Shore are always excited to see new business development in their community. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome Linda McIntosh and Jose Lemoyne, owners of Knackered Vintage to Modern Decor, to the Porter's Lake area. And whereas Knackered strives to provide unique vintage items which are recycled and repurposed for modern use, Knackered is also providing space for local Eastern Shore artists to sell their work. And whereas small businesses like Knackered are the backbone of Nova Scotia, their successes enrich our communities and create further opportunities for growth. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly join me in welcoming new business owners like Linda and Jose and wishing Knackered a successful future. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Inverness.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas baseball and softball have always been popular sports in Inverness County, and whereas the Inverness Regional Minor Ball Association is looking forward to another great season on the Ned McDonald Memorial Ball Field, which received significant upgrades in 2010. And whereas the driving force between minor ball and Inverness, behind minor ball and Inverness, are President Sandy Watling, Vice President Sean Cox, Treasurer Shauna Bennett, Secretary Donna Buckley, and a team of nine directors, including past President Leslie McKinnon. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly recognize the efforts of the entire Inverness Regional Minor Ball Association and wish them continued success in the summer of 2014. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Truro, Bible Hill, Millbrook, Salmon River.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas John McKenzie from Truro received the Caring Citizen Governor General's Award on Friday, February 21, 2014, and whereas John received this esteemed award for his 15-plus years of dedication to girls' rugby in Truro, coaching high school, provincial, and Atlantic levels, and whereas 19 young women from his past rugby teams put forth the application for this award, appreciating his mentoring, caring, and professionalism towards them and the game of rugby, encouraging women to participate in the sport. Therefore, be it resolved that the Nova Scotia Legislature congratulates John McKenzie for his dedication and leadership to girls' rugby in Truro. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Sackville Beaver Bank.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on the future day, I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas a group of Sackville residents in 2007 formed the Woodbine Family Association to provide hot meals to anyone over 50 who could not afford to make hot meals for themselves. And whereas over the years, in addition to providing meals, this group has raised money for many community projects, such as planting trees and the purchase of playground equipment. And whereas these dedicated individuals, Marina Herbert and Christine McCutcheon, along with the board of directors, volunteers, continue to provide meals free of charge to those in need. Anyone who can afford to pay is asked to pay $5 donation to keep the cupboard stocked, and they need not live in Woodbine Trailer Park. All are welcome. Therefore, be it resolved that the members of the House of Assembly recognize the Woodbine Family Association for their selfless dedication to providing for their neighbors. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Pictou East.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Lisa Jordan, assistant coach of Canada's Winter Olympic women's hockey team, was born and raised in Westville, and her proud hometown, along with the entire country, held their collective breath during the gold medal game and particularly held their breath when that Team USA shot hit the post while our goalie had him pulled. And whereas Lisa helped coach the team to a thrilling gold medal win, and the cheers in Westville joined those from coast to coast to coast. And whereas Lisa made her mark on the world stage, and it is with joy and appreciation that we welcome our golden girl back to Westville to congratulate her and celebrate her achievement. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly recognize and celebrate Lisa Jordan's great achievement. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye. Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. We'll now move on to orders of the day. I recognize the honourable member for Cole Harbour Eastern Passage.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Sandra Brownlee is an intuitive and artistic weaver and a notebook keeper who allows imagery to surface line by line, almost as if it records itself, and whereas she has received the Sadie Brofman Award, which is awarded to the outstanding artists with their excellence in fine arts, and whereas she has been chosen as one of seven recipients to receive the Governor General's Award in Visual and Media Arts. Therefore, let it be resolved that the members of this House of Assembly join me in congratulating Sandra Brownlee in receiving the 2014 Governor General's Award in Visual and Media Arts and wish her continued success in the future with her creative artistry. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye. Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The honourable member for Kings North.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas on February 18th, the Annapolis Valley Chamber of Commerce handed out the 2014 Valley Best Awards, and whereas CareForce was named Best Health Personal Care, and whereas CareForce works as a proud partner with a number of local organizations and individuals to provide leadership and quality health care. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House congratulate CareForce for being awarded Valley Chamber of Commerce Best Health / Personal Care for 2014. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye. Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The honourable member for Lunenburg.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Duke of Edinburgh's awards have been helping to shape young Canadians into citizens who give back to their communities and strive to be the best they can possibly be. And whereas youth between the ages of 14 and 24 have been participating in the program nationwide since 1963 to complete the three levels of standard, being bronze, silver, and gold. And whereas Allison Smith of Lunenburg has achieved all the requirements set out by the gold standard of the Duke of Edinburgh Awards. Therefore, let it be resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate Allison on her hard work and tremendous achievement in earning her gold standard. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The honourable member for Pictou West.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Mr. Dave Gunning of Scotch Hill Road, Lynesbrook, won the CBC Music Hockey Night in Canada Song Quest competition on January 1, 2014, and whereas Mr. Gunning's song was chosen the winner out of close to 1,000 other submissions from across Canada, and whereas Mr. Gunning will now have his song professionally produced and featured in a video montage for an opening sequence of a future Hockey Night in Canada broadcast. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate Mr. Dave Gunning on his win and wish him all the best in the future. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Victoria of the Lakes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day, I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Representative Volunteer Award given to volunteers who have made an outstanding contribution in their community has been awarded to Mr. Dan McNeil for his work in the community of Victoria County. And whereas for years, Mr. McNeil has volunteered his time and energy to grooming and maintaining the North Highlands Nordic cross-country ski trails. And whereas, through Mr. McNeil's work, he helps to maintain the North Highlands cross-country trails so that people from all over can come and enjoy one of the great activities Victoria County has to offer. Therefore, be it resolved that the House of Assembly recognize and congratulates Dan McNeil for his continued contributions to Victoria County. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Halifax Atlantic.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day, I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Shabukto Connections has been working in the Spryfield community since 1985, whereas this nonprofit organization has brought services such as Friends for Life, a childhood anxiety prevention program, and pathways to education to the Spryfield area, and is always looking at ways to enrich the community. Their latest partnership is with the Nova Scotia Legal Aid, now offering legal service every second Friday in Spryfield, and whereas on February 26, 2014, Shabukto Connections held their grand opening of their new office space at 531 Herring Cove Road, the new building provides them with the space they need to better serve the community. Therefore, be it resolved that members of the House of Assembly congratulate Shabukto Connections on their new building and their continued work to strengthen the community in the Spryfield area.
There has been...
Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Dartmouth South.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Dartmouth's Bridgecat Centre for Arts and Technology is a program for youths aged 14 to 19 whose potential for dropping out of school is imminent, and whereas Bridgecat is the first of its kind in Canada offering arts-based programming to disadvantaged youth, including materials for creative space for pottery, music recording, visual arts, video editing, poetry, and even cooking, and whereas under Executive Director David Napier and Program Director Sobaz Benjamin, Bridgecat recently moved into an historical building on Queen Street in Dartmouth in December of last year, establishing a creative environment to engage youth and encourage collaboration with their communities. Therefore, be it resolved, members of the House of Assembly applaud the efforts of Bridgecat in Dartmouth for their dedication to the empowerment of Nova Scotian youth and their commitment to enhanced community collaboration through exposure to the arts. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Timberley Prospect.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I will move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Jessica Bauer is an advocate for mental health awareness, in particular the area of youth mental health, and whereas Jessica is an exceptional young woman who has willingly shared her personal experiences with mental health to lobby for improved mental health services within the province, and whereas Jessica raises awareness of mental health issues amongst youth through Bell's Let's Talk program and by speaking and fundraising for Langhouse, a peer support organization for youth living with mental health, therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate Jessica Bauer and express their support for the importance of her work and the positive benefits it has on those that suffer from mental illness. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Clare Digby.
Mr. Speaker, I give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas 2014 marks the 30th anniversary of Le Gardier Familial de Clare, providing the most valuable service to young children and their families, and whereas the family home daycare program is designed to provide healthy, safe, and appropriate environments for young children who are cared for in approved private homes, and whereas for the past 30 years, the care provider and Clare have supplied the community with excellent daycare services throughout the municipality. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate the Gardier Familial de Clare on their 30th anniversary and wish them continued success in their future endeavours. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Cumberland North.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Dick Bristol of Amherst, Nova Scotia has received the 2014 Provincial Volunteer Award, and whereas this honour recognizes the tremendous contributions Dick Bristol has made to his community and to the province, and whereas Dick Bristol donates his time to help others by supporting the causes in which he believes in various ways, and especially through Dick's Jamboree, therefore be it resolved that the members of this House of Assembly commend Dick Bristol on being the honoured recipient of the 2014 Provincial Volunteer Award. Mr. Speaker, I hereby request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Service, Nova Scotia.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Catherine Talbot of Bridgewater has been recognized as the arthritis hero at an event in Halifax on February the 12th, 2014. And whereas Catherine, who lives with juvenile arthritis, has continued to be active in athletics, playing badminton, cross country, and basketball. And whereas Catherine is an example of what can be achieved with hard work, determination, and positive attitude. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly congratulate Catherine Talbot for the example she shows and for being recognized as this year's arthritis hero. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Communities, Culture and Heritage.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day, I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Una Launder of Dartmouth Coal Harbour is a canoe athlete and Canadian national team for the Canadian national team, 2013 ICF World Cup number 3, K4 500 meter bronze medal that she won in Poznan, Poland. 2012 Canadian champion and record holder for the IC 500 meter, 2011 gold medal Pan American Games in Mexico, 2010 Silver Medal Pan American Championships in Mexico City, K1 500 meter bronze medal Canadian championship, sprint championship, K1 1000 meter silver medal Canadian sprint championship, and whereas she has been a community ambassador, fundraiser for Special Olympics, and current student at Mount St. Vincent, and whereas Una has been selected as part of the RBC Olympians program, and she is an aspiring Olympian who has her sights on the 2016 Games in Rio. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly congratulate Una on her inclusion to the RBC Olympian program and wish her continued success in the future. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver and notice without passage of the debate.
We'll pass it. There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Fairview, Clayton Park.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Dr. Susie Brigham, Associate Professor in the Faculty of Education and Chair of the Alexa McDonough Institute for Women, Gender, and Social Justice at Mount St. Vincent University, organized the community-based project titled Refugees Learning and Storytelling Through Participatory Photography. And whereas the project's exhibit was designed to showcase the lives and experiences of Nova Scotia's immigrants and refugees, and in creating these pieces, project participants were able to document their unique perspectives while contributing to research and creating a shared understanding of the issues that affect them. And whereas the participants in this project were given the opportunity to share their settlement experiences with others through this public exhibit, which was displayed at the Keshen Goodman Library. Therefore, be it resolved that the members of this House of Assembly congratulate Dr. Brigham and all of the project's participants and wish them success in the future. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Halifax, Chibucto.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Daniel Campbell entered the Duke of Edinburgh program to perform service and acquire skills to help both himself and the community, and now in the future. And whereas Daniel volunteered at St. Catharines Elementary, increased his canoe and camping skills in the Annapolis Valley, improved his fitness and teamwork skills by playing with the Halifax Hawks, and obtained his driver's license. And whereas Daniel has worked very hard to complete all the goals set out for him, therefore, be it resolved that all the members of the House of Assembly congratulate Daniel Campbell on the hard work and the determination to earn the bronze level of the Duke of Edinburgh Award. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Guysborough, Eastern Shore, Tracadie.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas on Saturday, February 1st, 2014, the fourth annual Luke McDonald Memorial Pond Hockey Tournament was held on Morrison Lake near Mulgrave. And whereas the event, which has been held every year in early February, raises funds for memorial bursaries to remember Luke McDonald of Mulgrave. And whereas the tournament raised an astounding $11,318 that will be given to the graduating class of CEREC in the form of bursaries at their annual graduation ceremonies in June, therefore be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly recognize and extend our gratitude and condolences to Luke's family and friends in honor of his memory. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Justice and Immigration.
Good morning, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Edward John McBride was born in South Utica, New York, he found himself drawn to Nova Scotia after spending his honeymoon here with his wife, Mary Ann. Since then, he's been a key member of the academic community, spending 32 years with St. Mary's University, including 4 years with Dalhousie Law School. In 2012, Professor McBride was awarded an honorary doctorate of civil law by St. Mary's University, an honor very rightly deserved. Whereas Professor McBride was a beloved professor to many of his former students, including myself, he earned this admiration by teaching with the following philosophy in mind. Make students want to do it, then convince them they can do it. It's a viewpoint that encouraged many to reach their full potential. As my first-year political science professor, he often shared stories of his work with John F. K. Kennedy. His passion for politics left a lasting impression and undoubtedly had influence on propelling me to where I am today. Whereas Professor McBride has faced health challenges in recent years, he still enjoys hearing from his former students and learning about their accomplishments. You can see the pride sweeping over him as he hears story after story of how far some have gone. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of the House join me in wishing Professor McBride a very happy 80th birthday, and that we all recognize his deep impact on the minds of leaders, past and present. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Education and Early Childhood Development.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Chronicle Herald Nova Scotia Spelling Bee is open to homeschooled, public and private school students from grades 4 to 8 from anywhere in the province, and whereas each school that registered in the contest held a spelling bee contest to select the student who would advance to the provincial competition, where a total of 43 students were chosen, and whereas the contest winner received a $5,000 education bursary from the Nova Scotia egg producers and will represent Nova Scotia at the National Spelling Bee in Washington in May. Therefore, be it resolved, all members of this House of Assembly congratulate 13-year-old Ryan Spencer from Great Village, Colchester North, a grade 7 student from West Colchester Consolidated School in Bass River, for his dedication and hard work in successfully winning the Chronicle Herald Spelling Bee, and wish him success as he represents Nova Scotia in Washington. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice, passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye?
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Labour and Advanced Education.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Patty Howard began Kitchen Door Catering in 2006 in Bedford, offering chef-crafted menu items as well as take-home meals, both fresh and frozen. And whereas Kitchen Door Catering expanded their gourmet to-go food shop into downtown Halifax and recently began contract catering at the Alt Hotel. And whereas Kitchen Door Catering was the silver medal winner in the category of Small Business of the Year in the 2014 Halifax Business Awards presented by the Halifax Chamber of Commerce. Therefore, be it resolved, the members of this House of Assembly congratulate Kitchen Door Catering, a full-service off-site catering company, on their culinary and hospitality expertise. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye? Contrary minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Agriculture, Fisheries and Aquaculture.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice on a future day I shall move adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Justine Colley was born and brought up in the community of East Preston, and where she is now a student at St. Mary's University in Halifax, and is captain and guard of the St. Mary's Huskies basketball team, where she was selected and has played with Team Canada in the FIBA American Championships. With over 2,300 career points, she is Canadian interprovincial inter-university sports highest scoring player of all time for women's basketball. She also won the coveted NANCAP Award as CIA Player of the Year in Canadian Women's Basketball for 2 years in a row. Therefore, be resolved that all members of this House join me in congratulating Justine Colley for her outstanding contribution to women's basketball, not only in Nova Scotia, but in Canada. Mr. Speaker, after waivered notice and passage of debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for King's South.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Stephen Slip of Wolfville, through his long and fruitful career as a graphic designer in Nova Scotia, has made numerous contributions to our province's and country's cultural heritage. And whereas Mr. Slip has been commissioned by Canada Post to design 13 commemorative stamps over the past 30 years, and has also served on Canada Post's advisory committee from 2002 to 2008, and whereas Mr. Slip was recently commissioned by Canada Post to design a stamp commemorating Robertson Davies, which was launched in August 28, 2013. Therefore, be it resolved that the House of Assembly congratulates Stephen Slip on his illustrious career in design and his most recent commission from Canada Post. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Hammonds Plains, Lucasville.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'd like to introduce another resolution on your behalf, the Honourable Member from Eastern Shore. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas David Crawford of East Jezicook has been a longtime pillar of his community. David retired after 30 years of service working for the HRM. David is a devoted husband, father, and grandfather. Whereas David Crawford has taken an active role in his community throughout his life, David is an active member of his church, St. Barnabas, where he is a former warden. He is also past president of the Chesicoke Recreation Society and is current King Lion of the Chesicoke and District Lions Club. And whereas David Crawford, as King Lion of the Chesicoke and District Lions Club, has coordinated aid to countless families, businesses, and groups in their time of need. Therefore, be it resolved that members of this House of Assembly join me in thanking David Crawford for his continued commitment to help the people of Chesicoke area by his embodiment of the Lions Club motto, "We Serve." Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye. Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Pictou East.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day, I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Marcel D'Entremont of Marigamish and Pictou East was among the winners in this year's Nova Scotia Talent Trust Awards as the recipient of the $1,500 Portia White Award for his voice, and whereas Marcel is currently studying for his Master of Music in Voice Opera degree at the University of Toronto, and the Portia White Prize will help him pursue his studies, and whereas Marcel's accomplishments will be a terrific help in establishing his professional career. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate Marcel on this award and wish him success in his future musical endeavors. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye. Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Sackville-Beaverbank.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas for the past 4 years, Sackville Heights Elementary School in Middle Sackville has been offering the breakfast program. The greatest challenge has been to secure dedicated volunteers to give 45 minutes of their time. And whereas Upper Sackville resident Frances Hammond, one of five ladies from Sackville United Baptist Church, has risen early on Fridays to prepare and serve breakfast to any child who wants to attend the breakfast program. Each morning, an average of 50 students are served varying combinations of toast, bagels, juice, fresh fruit, cheese, and yogurt. And whereas as a nutritious breakfast is key to a successful day, academically and socially, without the dedication of volunteers like Mrs. Hammond, the breakfast program at Sackville Heights Elementary School could not be offered. Therefore, be it resolved that the members of the House of Assembly recognize Frances Hammond for her dedication and support to the Sackville Heights Elementary Breakfast Program. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Pictou West.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Highland Ford Sales Limited, located on Belotus Drive, Westville, supports local schools through a unique fundraising idea. And whereas Eric and Linda Barker, owners of Highland Ford Sales Limited, have generously assisted schools with fundraising with the Highland Ford Drive 4 UR School Days for many years. And whereas Highland Ford Sales Limited supports local schools by donating $20 for each test drive during the fundraising event, culminating in thousands of dollars over the years. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly thank Eric and Linda Barker, as well as the staff of Highland Ford Sales Limited, for their ongoing generous support to the schools in Pictou County. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Halifax Atlantic.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future date I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Spryfields Lions Club has organized the Renee Quigley Bowling Challenge for the last 11 years, and whereas this bowling challenge brings community business together every March for friendly competition and a fun-filled morning of bowling, and whereas all proceeds from the Renee Quigley Bowling Challenge go to support the Spryfield Boys and Girls Club. Therefore, be it resolved that members of the House of Assembly congratulate the Spryfield Lions Club on their continued commitment to organizing this community event and supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Spryfield. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Dartmouth South.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Dartmouth Players is in its 26th season in its home theatre of Crichton Avenue in Dartmouth, and whereas Dartmouth Players is celebrated as Dartmouth's only classic amateur community theatre, drawing audiences in the thousands for each performance run, and whereas Dartmouth Players cast and crew presented a highly praised performance of The Woman in Black from February 5th through the 22nd of 2014, therefore be it resolved that the members of this House of Assembly join me in congratulating the cast and crew of The Woman in Black and recognize the long-standing service of Dartmouth Players in our community and wish them many more years of continued success. Mr. Speaker, I ask for waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favor of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Timberley Prospect.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Mabel, Michael, and Rod McSween, owners and operators of Mabel's Farm Market, located at 3303 Prospect Road, Whites Lake, have been in business since April 2004, and whereas Mabel's Farm Market provides fresh fruits and vegetables, locally made baked goods and breads, and much more to residents of the Prospect communities, and whereas Mabel's Farm Market is appreciative and supportive of the communities they serve, therefore be it resolved that this Nova Scotia House of Assembly congratulate Mabel's Farm Market and wish them continued success in the future. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Clare Digby.
Mr. Speaker, I give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas on February 1, 2014, a fundraising hockey game was held at University of St. Anne to raise funds for the Lisa Thibodeau Work Fund administered by CORD, the Clare organization representing persons with disabilities. And whereas the charity hockey game was organized between the former Clare Lions Junior C hockey players and the Sea Star Ice Dogs hockey team. And whereas over 400 people attended this charity hockey game and raised $3,000 for the Lisa Thibodeau Work Fund, therefore be it resolved that all members of this House of Assembly congratulate and thank the organizers for their hard work in organizing the event and for reaching out to such a worthy cause. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Service, Nova Scotia, Municipal Relations.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas the Italy Cross Middlewood Fire Department has opened their new station, and whereas the new station was made possible because of the volunteers who donated time, supplies, and expertise to the build, and whereas the new station was celebrated at an open house inviting the public to meet the volunteers, members, and other community members, therefore be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly congratulate the Italy Cross Middlewood Fire Department, its members and volunteers, for their new station, and recognize the community spirit that is needed for a project such as this. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of the Environment.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas, at their monthly council meeting on November 19, 2013, the municipality of the County of Anakinish honoured Denise Fougier on 25 years of service, and whereas Denise is the administrative assistant with the county's recreation department and is an integral member of their team by taking the lead role on developing the municipality's quarterly newsletter and organizing their annual Canada Day celebrations, and whereas Warden Russell Boucher praised Denise's commitment and exceptional longevity and service. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly congratulate Denise on 25 years of service and for all her support and guidance she has provided to the people of Anakinish. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. The motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Fairview, Clayton Park.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Lisa Sullivan is a strong community advocate, a dynamic leader, and a generous member of the business community, and whereas Ms. Sullivan has created and organized the annual Fairview Family Days and the Freeman's Tree Lighting Ceremony, which have been both hugely successful in bringing the community together. And whereas Ms. Sullivan has dedicated her whole life to the improvements of her community and to the safety of our neighbourhood. Therefore, be it resolved that the members of this House of Assembly congratulate Ms. Lisa Sullivan in her continued pursuit of community togetherness and her overall drive to promote a safe and happy neighbourhood. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary-minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Halifax, Shabakto.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Justin Weigel entered into the Duke of Edinburgh's program to perform service and acquire skills to help both himself and the community, now and in the future, and whereas he undertook volunteering with the IWK, increased his canoe and camping skills in the Annapolis Valley, received his driver's license through the high school driving academy and improved his fitness levels by playing hockey with the Halifax Hawks. Whereas Justin has worked very hard to complete all the goals set out for him, therefore, be it resolved that all the members of this House of Assembly congratulate Justin Weigel on his hard work and determination to earn the bronze level of the Duke and Edinburgh Award. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Member for Guysborough Eastern Shore Tracadie.
Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that on a future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Ashley Sharp of Mosier River sparked an interest in humanitarian aid work through volunteering at the Gambia with Nova Scotia Gambia Association while earning her nursing degree, and whereas in August 2012 she went on her first mission with Doctors Without Borders in Katanga, Democratic Republic of Congo, for 9 months, and whereas she is currently working with Doctors Without Borders for 6 months in Bosangoa in the Central African Republic as an outreach nurse, traveling with a team to surrounding villages to provide health care to populations left without any assistance. Therefore, be it resolved that all members of the House of Assembly recognize Ashley and Doctors Without Borders for their noble work and be so ever mindful of the importance of their roles in the lives of so many. Mr. Speaker, I request waiver of notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed? It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Agriculture.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I hereby give notice that in the future day I shall move the adoption of the following resolution. Whereas Paul Adams was interested in photography as a child and knew this is where he wanted to be as an adult. Accordingly, he took a 2-year course in Nova Scotia Community College and now holds a diploma in digital imagery and photography, and later started his photography business part-time in 1998 and went full-time in 2004 to Adams Photography Services Incorporated. And whereas Paul believes in giving back to his community and does charitable work with the Sickle Cell Disease Association and his church, Emmanuel Baptist Church, as well as he goes to the schools and speaks to students about photography and career choices. Whereas Paul was awarded the Entrepreneur of the Year Award in 2012 by the Board of Directors of the Black Business Initiative, where he also won the Consumer Choice Award for the last 4 years. Therefore, be resolved that members of this House join me in congratulating Paul Adams for his many accomplishments in photography and giving back to his community. Mr. Speaker, I'd ask for waiver notice and passage without debate.
There has been a request for waiver. Is it agreed?
Agreed.
It is agreed. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. The Honourable Minister of Economic and Rural Development and Tourism.
Speaker, under do you wish to call it government business?
I recognize. We'll move on to orders of the day. Government business. And the Honourable Minister of Economic Development.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Speaker, would you please call Bill number 32, the Forestry Agreement Statutes Repeal Act.
We'll now have Bill number 32, the Forestry Agreement Statutes Repeal Act of 2014. The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I move that Bill number 32, an act to repeal statutes pertaining to forest agreements, be now read a second time. Mr. Speaker, as this House knows, the forestry sector has been undergoing a period of transformation and transitioning over the course of recent years. It is imperative that, as a legislature, we ensure that our legislation is reflective of those changes. Three of these acts being repealed today have not been used since 1960, Mr. Speaker. The Halifax Power and Pulp Company Limited Agreement Act
was enacted in 1962 for a newspaper plant to be built in Sheet Harbor, but the company never built the plant. In the early 1970s, the company stopped operating. The Oxford Lease Agreement Act was implemented in 1960 for a specific purpose and is now obsolete. The Bowater-Mersey Act was enacted in 1962, but the province never entered into the agreement, so it's appropriate to repeal. The Scott Maritimes Limited Agreement Act is still being used at the moment, but it lacks the flexibility needed to address today's industry and ensure compliance of forestry practices identified in the province's natural resources strategy. Mr. Speaker, I'm asking that you repeal it today, and once a new agreement comes into effect, it will be proclaimed. Of course, these legislative changes are happening in conjunction with investment in the innovation side of forestry, Mr. Speaker, identifying new harvesting methods and processes and markets for our products, along with our continued work with private woodlot owners across the province to help us address the fiber shortage that we have in the province of Nova Scotia. So this is part of a more robust strategy to support that forestry sector, Mr. Speaker. And with that, I'll take my seat. Thank you.
The Honourable Member for Pictou East.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it's my pleasure to rise today in support of Bill 32. And I know how eager the Minister was to get to the second reading of this bill, so I am delighted that I'm the first one to jump to my feet in support of his bill. Mr. Speaker, there's no doubt that the forestry industry has changed since the 1960s. In fact, it's hard to think of an industry that hasn't undergone significant change in the last 50 years. Bill 32 makes sense because part of our job here is to modernize outdated legislation and make sure that we are governed by legislation that makes sense. So making housekeeping changes like this is necessary, and we support that. But, Mr. Speaker, another part of our job here in this House of Assembly is to pass legislation that moves the province forward, to pass legislation that makes the lives of Nova Scotians easier and better. And today, as I look at this legislation, I am reminded of many things that the government is not doing. I am reminded of things that this department could be doing to make things better, but it is not. Mr. Speaker, I am left to wonder, where is the legislation that will truly innovate, strengthen, revolutionize our forestry industry? Forestry is a significant industry in Nova Scotia. It's an over $700 million a year industry. It employs over 10,000 people. And I want to see this government support what we know works. I can't help but ask, where is the bold action to help the silviculture industry that is so desperately underserviced? Silviculture works. We should be doing more silviculture work to make sure that our woodlands are more efficient and increase our yields. We have to be looking at how we finance silviculture work, because the silviculture fund is not working. Right now, silviculture contractors are not paid enough because rates haven't changed since years. So what happens is that contractors do the easy work and not the necessary work. They are not paid enough to, they are only paid enough to do the easy work, so they never get to the necessary work. That is backwards, and that needs to be fixed. And I'm concerned that this government is all too familiar with the concept of doing the easy work as opposed to the necessary work, because there is much this government can be doing to ensure that an appropriate amount of silviculture work is being done. So today I'm left to ask, where is that legislation? Today, with Bill 32, this government is doing some of the easy work. When will they, as a department, get around to dealing with the necessary issues and doing the necessary work? Necessary work like introducing legislation to take the mystique and confusion out of the process regarding who gets access to our Crown lands and how. We'd like to see this department working to make the process of allocating access to Crown lands an open, fair, transparent process. When the province is going to open access to Crown land, why isn't it standard procedure that a public, fair tender process be used? If we're going to allow access to blocks of Crown land, we should have an open, fair process. And Mr. Speaker, recently we saw 15 companies granted six-month harvesting licenses for the former Bowater lands. What process did these companies follow to obtain these licenses? Did they bid? Did they apply? And I can name Nova Scotian employers that would have appreciated just the opportunity to be in the running for one of these licenses. But instead, sadly, they read about it in the paper that the licenses were issued behind closed doors. In other provinces, they tender for access. Why aren't we looking at that? Why don't we tender Crown land in small blocks that the average Nova Scotian operator, the small guy, can get access to these lands and harvest fiber? So, Mr. Speaker, it again looks like the government is doing the easy work but not addressing the necessary work. And I am left to ask, where is the leadership when it comes to access to Crown lands? Why is the government's first move of this spring session a housekeeping bill, a few strokes of the pen? Well, as we stand here today, Nova Scotians are being told that their important health services are being cancelled and postponed. Members opposite, we on this side, are ready to get to the real work, the necessary work of running the province. And hopefully, you will be soon too. So, Mr. Speaker, in closing, our caucus will support Bill 32, but we urge the minister and we urge the government to use their office to support this industry and all industry in Nova Scotia and get to the necessary work of providing jobs and providing hope to hundreds of Nova Scotian families. Thank you.
The Honourable Member for Queens Shelburne.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I have a few words, a few minutes, if I could, of Bill number 32, the Forestry Appeal Act. Mr. Speaker, it's unfair to those interested in this important rural industry to call this bill housekeeping. And I know the minister calls it housekeeping. I actually noted the official opposition also used that. Without coupling it together with a vision for this important future of this industry, simply unfair to call this label it as housekeeping. Mr. Speaker, this is the cart before the horse or the chicken before the egg. To not couple the Act appeals with a real vision, with the real vision of the forestry, does a disservice to our rural communities across Nova Scotia who rely heavily on this sector. If the minister is serious about his job, he would truly be interested in transparency. By now, we know that if whatever the full forestry utilization agreement is being negotiated would now be living up to the spirit of the forestry utilized agreement that we as a government most recently agreed to with Port Hawkesbury paper. To call this bill housekeeping and not offer up any commitments related to the current agreement negotiation isn't just unfair interest to all Nova Scotians, as my counterpart suggested. This is simply being lazy. Mr. Speaker, a simple question. Will this meet the spirit of the new forest utilization agreement that we introduced or made with Port Hawkesbury paper? People across Nova Scotia wants to know. They want to know simple questions like, will people have access for firewood? Will they have access for commercial fiber? Questions is also about what this new government has for a vision when it comes to the forestry. And that question when it comes to a word called certification. To me, to our party, certification, one important meaning. It means, certainly to myself and to members of this party, that that we need to make sure that wood supply goes to the right home, such as wood that needs to be placed for its highest value. Saw logs are stud wood to sawmills, and pulp wood certainly would go for pulp, and biomass for biomass. And most importantly, and we cannot forget, that simply firewood to help keep Nova Scotians warm in their homes on a yearly basis. These are simple questions, Mr. Speaker, but there's absence in the reply from the minister. Mr. Speaker, I ask certain questions like why the minister calls this bill housekeeping, like this. Why can't he indicate and ask these questions and answer the questions? Questions such as, if any new agreement, will it be available online? Will it be aiming at, or will he be aiming at, or this bill be aimed at reducing clear cutting? Will it increase the wood fiber supply for private landowners? And will it aim to improve sustainable harvesting techniques? Will it be a progress report after 2 years? And will all lands under this new agreement adhere to the Forest Stewardship Council or something better? Will this agreement assist in reaching any of the land protection goals? These are all fair questions, Mr. Speaker, and the minister has an opportunity to answer some of this and just simply not say this is all about housekeeping. Again, simply put, will it meet the spirit of the new forest utilization license agreement that the previous government made with Port Hawkesbury Paper? What vision does this government have to have such a vital, important rural industry, and isn't it an introduction, again, of housekeeping bill, as he calls it, a perfect opportunity to answer some of these most important questions, Mr. Speaker? Mr. Speaker, Nova Scotians are getting nervous. I repeat, they are getting nervous of this government's unwillingness to act and say anything that has some substance. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you again.
If I'm to recognize the Minister of Natural Resources, it'll be to close debate on Bill number 32, Forestry Agreement Statutes Repeal Act 2014.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Just to address some of the issues that were brought up by our members opposite and to clarify some information for the House, I'm actually proud to be part of a government that took obsolete pieces of legislation that have been on the books since 1960 and repealed them today. Those have sat through... These pieces of legislation have been on the books for decades, and no government has moved to make any changes on them, except for ours today, Mr. Speaker. Related to the questions around the Western Crown Land Management Process and fiber allocation, and the overall success of the forestry sector, Mr. Speaker. We cannot legislate prosperity in this legislature. We cannot legislate more fiber for our woodcutters. What we can do is ensure that our legislation is up to date, is relevant, and reflects the changes that we have seen in the forestry sector and helps move the forestry sector forward. I'm proud to say that we're doing that today, Mr. Speaker. As I mentioned, this legislation is happening along with a significant effort on the department side to support the forestry sector. Our efforts are on investing in innovation, identifying new markets, ways of harvesting, new processes that our foresters can use across this province to do it more effectively and to make more money while doing it. And also, as the members know, one of the biggest challenges that we face in our forestry sector in this province is lack of a secure fiber source. We have the second lowest amount of crown land in the country after PEI, Mr. Speaker. We have the second highest amount of protected land in the second highest percentage amount of protected land in the country, Mr. Speaker. This creates challenges for our forestry sector when it comes to accessing fiber. Despite what the member from the NDP caucus says, I can't legislate more fiber to grow in this legislature. But what I can say, Mr. Speaker, is this government has taken a very different approach than the previous government when it comes to supporting our forestry sector. The previous government's efforts were focused on bailing out big pulp and paper mills and throwing a lot of resources that way. We have said no. Northern came to us. similar to Port Hawkesbury and Bowater, that came to the previous government and asked for money. Northern also asked for a blanket license to cut across this province. We said no, Mr. Speaker. That is a significant policy shift from what the previous government did and what this government is doing. And I'll tell you, Mr. Speaker, what I'm hearing from Nova Scotians across this province, they are very happy with that move that we made. The member opposite from the Conservative caucus asked some questions related to the Western Crown land allocations. As he knows, as was stated in this legislature and publicly, that management plan was a result of extensive public consultation. And I will inform the member that there were no companies that came forward that asked for an allocation on those Western Crown lands that didn't receive one. We are aware of the fiber challenges that this province is facing, and we did our very best to accommodate all the requests that came in from sawmillers, particularly from the West. And I want to assure that member that everybody, small mills, large mills, all alike, have been working together on this plan. They were supportive of it, and we'll be working with them further to allocate the long-term allocations, Mr. Speaker. I thought that was important to note as well. There was two companies that hadn't traditionally received allocations from the West. There were anomalies in this process. One was Brooklyn Power, an important organization down in Liverpool. They ran out of a fiber source, so we did our very best to accommodate their request, which is a new request. And the other anomaly was Northern Pulp. And of course, what this government was doing was maintaining a commitment that was made very clearly by the previous government back in January 2013. It is true, and everybody that has seen all the facts knows it's true, including a former staff person in the Premier's office.
Order, please. The Honourable Minister of Natural Resources has the floor.
Mr. Speaker, it's not even debatable whether the past government actually allocated $125,000 to Northern or not. And if any members in the NDP bench want to ask me a question in QP, I'd be happy to engage you in that conversation. So we had to maintain that commitment, Mr. Speaker. The reason why we did that, it was a fulsome discussion. It entailed a lot of thought on our end, and we thought it was not fair to the company or to the employees. They were informed over a year ago that they would be receiving this allocation. They'd been investing in their company. They'd been investing in their workforce, and we did not think it would be fair for government to renege on that commitment, so we kept it. In order to reach that commitment, we did need to allocate some fiber from the West, which we did. Mr. Speaker, again, this legislative review is part of a larger ongoing effort to revitalize our forestry sector, work in partnership with them, and unlike the previous government, which brought in regressive policies that we've heard from the forestry sector, hurt them very specifically, we're working with that sector to move it forward. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker.
The motion is for a second reading of Bill number 32, Forestry Agreement Statutes Repeal Act. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried.
Bill number 32, entitled an act to repeal certain statutes pertaining to forestry agreements.
Ordered that this bill be referred to the Committee on Law Amendments. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Thank you, Speaker. Would you please now call for second reading, Bill number 33, the Fair Registration Practices Act.
We'd like to have second reading of Bill number 33, Fair Practices Registration Act, amended. The Honourable Minister of Labour.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I move that Bill number 33, an act to amend Fair Registration Practices Act, now be read a second time. Mr. Speaker, I'm sure everyone in this House would agree that it's in the best interests of Nova Scotians, our businesses, and our workforce if government can make it easier for professionals to work in the province. That's exactly what we're doing with the changes we're introducing to the Fair Registration Practices Act. This act ensures that people who have trained outside the province receive a fair review of their qualifications. It's about giving provincially, nationally, and internationally trained professionals timely, clear and understandable information about registration and licensing requirements and processes to help them find a job in their chosen profession. Under the Act, regulatory authorities are responsible for carrying out registration practices that are objective and transparent. They also must set the standards or certification for an occupation, assess the qualifications of workers against this criteria, and recognize if a candidate meets the standards or requirements to work in that occupation. Some of the regulated authorities currently covered in the Act include the Association of Professional Engineers, the College of Physicians and Surgeons, the Institute of Chartered Accountants, and the College of Pharmacists. Mr. Speaker, these regulatory bodies are required under legislation to report their registration practice, review, and appeal processes and fees so that we can ensure they are accountable and that their practices are objective and transparent. Changes to the Act will make it clear that all regulatory bodies that oversee professions are subject to the Act and biannual reporting, and they will ensure that people who have trained outside the province continue to receive a fair review of their qualifications. Mr. Speaker, these changes will also allow the Minister responsible for Labour and Advanced Education to add new regulatory bodies without seeking approval from Executive Council. This will streamline the process, allowing more occupations to become recognized under the Act more quickly. Mr. Speaker, the changes we've introduced will support the recognition of more trained professions and help these individuals who offer in-demand skills ensure that these individuals who offer in-demand skills are ready to work in Nova Scotia. I'm very pleased to be tabling this legislation, and I'm available for any questions you may have. Thank you.
The Honourable Member for Pictou Centre.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I am pleased to rise today in the House to support this bill. This legislation will increase the accessibility to the annual report while removing cumbersome regulations and processes. We encourage the government to continue to work with professionals and make it easier for them to come to Nova Scotia. We would like to see more legislation like this, and we would like to see it expanded to address the challenges associated with attracting and maintaining trained immigrants. Hopefully, there is more to come from the Department of Labour and Advanced Education to help support the Ivany goal of doubling immigration. Mr. Speaker, in Nova Scotia, we have real demographic challenges. Nova Scotia now has the oldest age profile of any Canadian province except Newfoundland and Labrador. We are currently projected to have 100,000 fewer working age people by 2036 than we had in 2010, a nearly 20% decline in the labour pool. Mr. Speaker, this bill is a good first step, but it is time for this government to act swiftly to tackle the challenges that have been identified by the Ivany Commission and others. The cost of tinkering around the edges is too high. Mr. Speaker, after those few words, I'll take my seat.
The Honourable Member for Cape Breton Centre.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, just to say a very few short words of this, there's no sense of being redundant. I think we agree with the direction this bill is going in, and we would hopefully see that this would be a part of a more fulsome exercise by this government as it relates to immigration. We realize how important that is to this province, and we look forward for this bill going forward, and we look forward to this government bringing forward a more fulsome and robust bill that would help us to attract and bring and retain immigrants to this great province. So with those few words, Mr. Speaker, I take my place.
If I'm to recognize the Minister of Labour, it will be to close debate on Bill number 33.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I thank the members opposite for their remarks and especially for their brief remarks. I now close second reading on Bill 33, an Act to amend the Fair Registration Practices Act.
The motion is to close second reading on Bill number 33, Fair Practices Registration Act amended. Would all those in favour of the motion please say aye. Contrary-minded, nay. The motion is carried.
Bill number 33, entitled An Act to Amend Chapter 38 of the Acts of 2008, the Fair Registration Practices Act.
Ordered that this bill be referred to the Committee on Law Amendments. The Honorable Government House Leader.
Merci, Mr. Speaker. Would you please call for second reading Bill number 34, the Notaries and Commissioners Act.
We'll now have second reading of Bill number 34, the Notaries and Commissioners Act. The Honorable Minister of Justice and Immigration.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I move that Bill number 34, Amendments to the Notaries and Commissioners Act, be read a second time. And I'm pleased to have the opportunity this morning to tell you the importance of these amendments. Mr. Speaker, when legal documents are entered into evidence in a court of law, it's required that the party who made these statements swear or affirm their truth. This oath or affirmation must be taken by a commissioner of oath. The Minister of Justice appoints the commissioner of oath under this act. There are certain professions, by virtue of their office, who automatically have legal authority to administer oath and take affidavits, declarations, and affirmations concerning any matter that comes before a court in the province of Nova Scotia. There are also other provincial statutes that authorize Commissioner of Oaths to take these declarations. Mr. Speaker, these professions include the following under our Act: Barristers of the Supreme Court of Nova Scotia, Canadian Armed Forces while on active duty, MLAs while she or he are members of the House of Assembly, Chief Officers of Municipal Police Departments, NRCMP members. The amendments proposed today would add to the list and allow licensed funeral home directors to also be commissioners of oath, Mr. Speaker. Currently, a licensed funeral home director who wants to become a commissioner of oath must go through an application process. This application process requires them to pay a fee of almost $129 to be appointed for a 5-year appointment as a commissioner of oath. Once they've been appointed as a commissioner of oath, they can then charge a fee of $19.35 for providing their service. Mr. Speaker, the proposed amendments would give licensed funeral home directors these powers automatically, without the need for an application and without the payment of a fee. Furthermore, what it will do, Mr. Speaker, is if these amendments are adopted, they would no longer be able to charge for providing the service under the Act. These amendments will ensure a couple of things. Licensed funeral home directors are able to provide this important service to Nova Scotians, and it will make things so much easier for families who have lost a loved one. When someone passes, Mr. Speaker, there's a lot of paperwork that needs to be completed, and oftentimes the paperwork is done at the funeral home. Mr. Speaker, with this amendment, funeral home directors will now be able to finalize some of these official documents and save grieving families time and money. At the end of the day, Mr. Speaker, commissioners of oath provide a valuable service to anyone going through a court process. This is an important service, and expanding the number of people who can provide this service to include licensed funeral home directors automatically will lessen the burden and inconvenience on Nova Scotians when a loved one has died, and it will also make it more accessible for everyone by helping to ensure that there is a visible place in more communities across Nova Scotia where citizens can go to swear or affirm the truth of their legal documents. It's for this reason, Mr. Speaker, that we're proposing the amendment. Thank you.
The Honourable Member for Inverness.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you. We will be supporting this legislation, Mr. Speaker. Giving legal authority to funeral directors to take declarations is something that's going to make it easier for families in their time of grievance. They're grieving for loved ones, and I believe it's something that makes sense. We're
pleased to let it pass through the legislature, and I won't take up any more time. Let's speed it through the process. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable Member for Sackville-Cobequid.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We do support this piece of legislation. I think it's important at any time the government can support those families who might be suffering a loss through this. And I think allowing this to happen will ease some of that burden that is placed on families. But I do feel compelled, Mr. Speaker, being a member of this House of Assembly for almost 11 years, to ask how much more will the current government support those who find themselves with a loss of a loved one. I'm going to echo the voices of one of our colleagues from Digby, who for many, many years stood in this House and asked a number of governments, when will they take the taxes off funerals? So I would hope that voice is echoing through the current government, and maybe the minister will answer if they're contemplating taking the taxes off funerals, which would support families in Nova Scotia. Thank you.
If I'm to recognize the Minister of Justice, it'll be to close debate on Bill number 34.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, and I'm very pleased to move unanimously, I guess with the consent of the House, these very important amendments, which will lessen the burden on grieving families. Thank you very much.
The motion is to close debate on Bill number 34, Notaries and Commissioners Act. Oh, close second reading, or for second reading. My breakfast is worn off. To close second, the motion is for second reading, Bill number 34, Notaries and Commissioners Act. My apologies. All those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried.
Bill number 34, entitled an Act to amend Chapter 312 of the Revised Statutes 1989, the Notaries and Commissioners Act.
Ordered that this bill be referred to the Committee on Law Amendments. The Honourable Government House Leader.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. That concludes the government's business for today. We will meet again on Monday, March the 31st, from the hours of 7 p.m. till 10 p.m. The order of business will be, after the daily routine, under government business, second reading of Bill number 35, which was introduced today, and if time permits, possibly some address and reply. With that, Mr. Speaker, I would move that the House do now rise to meet again on Monday, March 31st, from 7 till 10 p.m.
The motion is that the House rise to meet again on Monday, March 31st, between the hours of 7 p.m. and 10 p.m. Would those in favour of the motion please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary minded, nay. Motion is carried. Thank you.